I'm going to look back a wee bit again at Wednesday there, and I had a look at the team lines, and as you say, Archie Meekison was there, Kerr Smith was there, Louis Appert was there, and Logan Chalmers was there. There can't be many teams that will have not just four academy players in their first team in the Scottish Premiership, but four academy players of the same group in the first team of the Premiership. That's something that you must be pretty proud of.
The whole club should be, but we don't do it because we're proud, and we're a very humble group. You know, we're not doing it for that. We want to develop young players, not just Scottish players, but young players. And hopefully if we can get as many young lads from the area through into the Dundee United first team, that would be a brilliant thing to be able to do. I would love to be able to have a whole team of home-produced players. I'd love to try and be able to do that. And I think I think as a club, we would love to be able to try and achieve that. But certainly, the boys deserve their opportunity. I think that's the important thing. It wasn't, we just didn't put them in and go, look at us, we want everybody to say well done. They've done really, really well, and there's more of them. There is more that are out on loan that we felt were a wee bit ahead of this group. So we put them out on loan. It's a Mockery and Nielsen, Fotheringham, all out on loan because we felt they needed that type of challenge. And these were the ones that just stayed and trained with the first team because these were a wee bit younger. But they've skipped on. So they've skipped on and caught up, and now, so it's an exciting time for us that we look around and we go, got quite a lot of good young talent here now, and with the right nurturing and opportunity, we could have some real good, exciting times and keep the club competitive in the Scottish Premiership with our own homegrown players. So that's what we're trying to do.
Looking at the game on Sunday, it's the last game of the season. You can still obviously, you know, move about with the positions in the league if you know, you get a victory and things from there. But what do we expect to see on Sunday? Is there anything different that might come along from Dundee United on Sunday with the last game of the season coming along?
I think we want to try and form this identity of us being a high pressing, high tempo team that attacks and defends really well, but takes chances and wants to score goals. That's what we're trying to build towards. So hopefully we'll see a step further towards that for longest. And some of the games we haven't done it for long enough. And then some of the games we've done it over the whole course of the game, but haven't done it game to game. But I can assure everybody that's the team that I want. That's the identity of the team and the type of player that I want to have here is the ones that can play that type of football. So hopefully we take a step again towards that on Sunday, as we did on Wednesday when we made so many changes and we played really well for long periods of the game. But still, yeah, we've still got stuff to work on. But we're certainly moving in the right direction as a group.
Last one for me. We talked briefly about what my summer holds, obviously, and where I'm going to be with it from there. But for yourself, when the final whistle blows on Sunday afternoon and the season finishes until the first day back at St Andrews for pre-season, beginning end of June, beginning of July, Sam, what does it hold for Mickey Mellon in that period?
Probably constantly on the phone. Got a lot to sort out either with the players here. I want to speak to probably pretty much most of the players and speak to them about the season that they've just had and what I expect probably going forward with them, give them some new benchmarks that I want them to hit and what I need them to improve on. And then having a look to see if there's maybe something out there in certain areas of the pitch that we don't have in the building that we might have to bring in. We're always working hard to try and do that. And then just enjoy sunny, bonny Scotland. Because don't forget, I'm new back up here, so this is all new to me. So Scotland without lockdown, I'm looking forward to that. But we'll only get 4 weeks, which is incredible. We'll only get 4 weeks off. Then it's 3 weeks pre-season. which is short as well, but because we're only getting 4 weeks. And then the Betfred Cup starts, and away we go again. And then hopefully the fans will be in, and away we go. And we'll be doing all this all over again.
Well, the good news is coming certainly today from the SFA that there'll be 2,000 Scotland Supporters Club fans and at Hampden for both the games, and 2,500 at Wembley. So it's certainly looking like the fans are going to be back in. And of course, you might catch a wee bit of the Euros yourself.
Oh, without a doubt, yeah. Can't really look forward to it. I mean, it's some really exciting games to watch, haven't we? And I've obviously, because my kids were born in England, they'll soon be told who they're supporting. So we'll be making sure that quickly gets sorted out. There'll be no uncertain terms about that one for the first time. So we'll have some good fun with that. But I'm really looking forward to it. It'll be brilliant, and we'll all look forward to that. And the pubs will all open, and we can hopefully get out this virus and get back to normal again.
I'm going to start off with looking back at the game on Wednesday night. There, you had, as well as yourself, there was Kerr on the park, there was Louis on the park, and there was Logan on the park. Did that kind of make the surroundings a wee bit easier for you, because these are guys who you've come through the system with?
Absolutely. You know, you come through it, and I've known the boys for, you know, a long time. And I think that also, like you said, it does make it easier, and the fact that you know how each other play a lot more. And you know, we're good mates. So, you know, it's always good to come on and see that we're all succeeding in that way. So, no, definitely.
And when the ball came in from Logan, when he was out wide and you swept it into the net, I could see how subdued you were, obviously, when you scored that goal, and you know how much it meant to you. So, I mean, what was it like to get that first goal, that first team goal for United?
You know, I think it was something, you know, it's always in your head when you want to come in these games and you want to ultimately score or assist. And I think when I hit the shot, you know, I seen it going in, and when I went in, I was just like, I'm just going to have to celebrate, because, you know, it does mean a lot for me. You know, I've been here since I was 7, so, you know, it's a big thing making it through the academy and then coming into the first team and making such an impact. So, I mean, you can see my celebration, how buzzing I was.
And looking towards the game at the weekend, it's a Sunday midday kickoff away to St Mirren. You're hoping to be involved in that, but again, just being involved in and around the first team must make a huge difference, obviously, to the development of where you are in the game.
Oh, absolutely. You know, even just training with them every day, you know, there's a very good quality group of players. You know, they're great guys. They, you know, helped me a lot with mentoring me, and especially with the first team staff as well. They've been great with me. So, you know, whether, you know, I'm playing or I'm not, I'm still improving in different areas. So, yeah, no, I can only gain experience and gain quality from training with this group.
And the last one for me is, it's really about the development system that's in place at Dundee United. Players of similar sort of age to yourself coming through the academy, getting opportunities at the game, but probably more importantly, getting the opportunities to get out there and play football on loan spells at other things. How important is that for people like you to get that opportunity to get the first team football?
I think, obviously, Dundee United have a big emphasis on playing, the promoting the academy and promoting the players from the academy to come into the first team. I think that's always the pathway that, you know, we've got to this club. And whether that's putting you out on loan for experience or playing you in the first team if you know you're ready. And I think that's what we've got it really well at this club, is putting you in at the right time, and then knowing when to put you in and when not to, sort of thing. So, you know, I think with the coaching staff and, you know, people like Tony Ashgar and stuff like that, and who have all helped me with, you know, the loan spells or when I come back and train in for, you know, a couple of weeks, you know, I didn't go straight in. And that's where, you know, you've got to work and show that you can come on.